so much. Nothing like a moment of perfect stillness.
Why is it preferable to have stillness?
Petra? Please don't sneak up on me like that! Oh, you're here too, Professor? What's going on?
I was asking my question first. What are you enjoying about air that is still?
Still air makes me feel better, that's all. It means you're in a nice, closed-off space where you can hide.
But spaces that are wide and open are wonderful. Places like forests and oceans.
Guess we'll have to agree to disagree about that.
I am not understanding your answer, but I am appreciating your explanation. I am reminded. I was wanting to ask if you wish to be going to the forest or ocean with me.
What? What part of anything I said would make you think I wanted that? So, your grandfather is in trouble. He's trying to lend us soldiers from Bridget, but the church is sending messengers there because they'd be in trouble if the Empire gets stronger.
You are saying messengers, but the truth is they are a threat. Bridget is having no power to refuse.
I get it, but what does this have to do with me?
Professor was asking this of me. I was told, if I am going to a faraway place, to be taking Bernie with me, since she is hiding away.
What? Professor? What did I do to deserve this? Haven't I gone out of my room enough lately? You say that, but I don't think I'm ready for this.
Bernie, I'm wanting this as well. Please, join me.
Since you put it that way, Petra, I'll think about it. Do you really want me to go, Professor? All right. I'll lend a hand. For everyone's sake.
What is the point of lending a hand? Are you not needing both of them to battle?
What? No, it's a figure of speech. Oh, don't make me imagine that!
Well, come back.
Thank you.
Professor! This is bad! The enemy's already here!
In strength, the enemies may be winning. But I am having an idea. I have been hearing that my friends are being imprisoned in the Western Stronghold. We will be taking the Stronghold and releasing our allies. Do not let loose your hope.
What? That side's crawling with enemies! We should go east! Way fewer of them over there.
I'm awake.
For the Empire!
I'll cut through.
I'll cut you down!
One to remember.
What's my strategy?
More fighting.
Next.
Let's clean up.
Put me in there.
Ready for anything.
I do this for all of us.
I'll cut a bloody path.
I'm good now.
I will prevail.
Let's see how they like this!
Going down.
Better than I thought.
Amazing!
Another victory.
I do this for all of us.
I will prevail.
I'm awake. One to remember.
Live, fight. No time for pity.
I am. What's my strategy?
It's over.
This could turn the tides.
Not for myself, for everyone.
Put me in there.
More fighting. Let's clean up. Very impressive.
Ready for anything.
What's this? You there! Identify yourself!
Of the stronghold has been completed. Our friends from the stronghold will soon be aiding us in battle.
Fine display.
Let's try some.
You're better than I thought.
I'll cut through.
Reinforcements are ready. Let us attack with each other.
Your death is not in vain.
This wouldn't have happened in my youth.
Pointless.
I came here to ask the people of Bridget not to join forces with our enemies. Looks like the Empire had the same idea. Let's block the road and cut them off!
If they are blocking the road, I will not have the ability to be seen my grandfather. They must be moving quickly.
Feels good to fight for our cause.
Bridget will not become a puppet of the Empire. The Knights of Saros won't let it happen!
Fighting. Stop them!
this for all of us. Will this ever end? I will prevail.
To survive, I will win!
My heart burns with pride.
For the Empire!
Yours is an honorable death. Bernie's unstoppable!
I'll cut through.
Let's clean up.
It is done. Now I can be meeting my grandfather. We must be moving with haste.
Finally over? Whew. All right, let's get out of here. This isn't exactly, the ideal environment for a recluse, you know.
I will be speaking with my grandfather. Once he is convinced, I will be returning. Professor, everyone, please be waiting here. Enemies may still be nearby.
Got it. We'll wait right here. And if anyone comes, the professor will handle it. Right, Professor?
Vegetation around here is pretty different from the kinds we usually see. It may be no good for a recluse, but the forest does have its own charms, doesn't it? Didn't you know? I love greenery! Especially carnivorous plants. They're my favorite! Yes, They just sit there, nice and still, and wait for their dinner to come to them! How great is that? And they all look so unique, too! What? Don't you think so? Oh, look! Petra's back! Sorry to be making you wait. I have spoken with him. It's been a long time since you've seen your grandfather, huh? How'd it go?
As is usual, my grandfather was well and strong. He was saying that he will be supporting us and giving us troops.
That's great! So we did it?
We did. You have my thanks. Ever since we were losing the war to the Empire, Bridget has been viewed as a vassal state. But with Fodlan at war, it is a chance for Bridget to be changing our situation. Our cooperation today is part of that chance. Bridget is wanting equality with Fodlan. We will be working hard to make this happen. Bernie? What is it you are feeling?
You're amazing, Petra. You went all by yourself to a foreign country? You worked hard for your homeland, and you achieved your goal.
I'm always focused on my own problems, and I barely ever get anywhere.
That is not the truth. You were fighting hard for me. You came here to be helping everyone. You were not thinking only of yourself. I am never doubting that you are working hard. We will be working together to keep moving forward to the future.
You really mean it? That's so nice!
And you were telling me about your interest in foreign vegetation. That is one reason why I wanted to be bringing you here. Did it make you happy?
It did! It was really exciting!
I've got so many drawings I need to do before we head back. I might even have enough to make into a book!
Yeah, I should do that! Wanna help, Professor?
There. We must rethink the supply route now that the battle lines have moved. This one will be Hubert, and Count Burgley's will oversee this force here. Ah, Professor, is something wrong? Sorry, I thought I had a bit more time before the council meeting. True, though ideally I'd like to hand off anything I can to my subordinates. But while we're on the front lines, I can't help but worry about every little thing. Now, let's see.
Pardon, Your Majesty. An urgent matter.
What's happened?
There is an army from Almira at Fodlan's throat. Reports indicate it is of appreciable size.
Thank you.
steep mountain range runs along the border between Fodland and Almira. That mountain range is called Fodland's Throat. The sturdy fortress built within those mountains is called Fodland's Locket. It occupies the sole path through. The Church and the Alliance nobles built the Locket to safeguard against Almiran invasion.
Normally, House Goneril watches over the fortress. In times of trouble, the lords join together to protect it. But I assume it would be too difficult to defend against this incursion with only the troops of Goneril.
The situation has been precarious for House Goneril since Holst fell ill. The heir to House Goneril, renowned for his bravery, he is Hilda's elder brother.
Holst is a formidable commander. It's only logical that House Goneril would struggle in his absence. The Alliance is shattered. They can't request soldiers from the surrounding lords. And the Imperial troops stationed there can't be relocated so easily. The best course of action is for us to go out there and deal with this ourselves. It's critical for us to protect that location. This is our chance to prove that we won't allow it to fall.
Yes. It is to the benefit of our future governance not to abandon it. It seems this must be done. Will you assist us?
We'll depart after you finish making preparations. Move swiftly. We must move before the Almiran army crosses the Throat. It seems we made it in time. Let's help the soldiers of House Goneril withdraw. The Black Eagle Strike Force will protect Fodland's Locket.
Support! We're saved!
Reinforcements? And that flag belongs to the Imperial Army! Ha! A fine enemy indeed! Break through the Locket and make a name for yourself. No need to be shy. Strike all at once!
We fight to protect Fodland. If the defensive line is broken, we fail. Our enemies are many, but we can use the terrain to our advantage and stop them where they stand.
There's no stopping me.
Ready for anything.
For the Empire!
I will prevail.
Me in there.
I'll cut through.
I'll cut a bloody path. What's my strategy?
More fighting. Let's clean up.
Going for the kill.
Thinning their numbers.
Truly impressive. I'm awake.
Do this for all of us.
Stay down.
Predictable.
Thinning their numbers.
Yeah!
Watch and learn.
I could go another few rounds.
Her will demands it.
Won't stop me.
got to try.
Stay down. Stay down. Let's clean up. Thinning their numbers. More fighting. Appreciate it.
I must commend you for your courage, seeing as how you dared to stand against me.
This is how far I go. Unbelievable. What a scary one.
Dare! Impossible! Everyone withdraw! Run!
No matter how many times you attack, we will never allow you to capture the throat. The Almiran troops are difficult opponents. For now, I would much rather focus on Fodlan's internal territories. I hope they don't mount another attack anytime soon.
Thank you so much.
The Almiran army retreated. Their casualties were numerous. As I understand it, they won't be attempting another invasion anytime soon. Still, we must prepare the local troops before their enemy returns. Indeed. But if possible, I would like to foster amicable relations with them. Unlike Fodlan, Almira is not a land ruled by blind fealty to the goddess. I believe we need only to communicate openly with them and respect the differences between our cultures. If we do that, we should be able to have a meaningful dialogue with them, one more promising than what we can expect from followers of the goddess. Hubert. What did Duke Goneril say?
He expresses his sincere gratitude to Lady Edelgard. In addition, he would like to leave the protection of the throat to Imperial troops from now on.
Is that so? How reasonable of him. By the way, what was it that ailed Holst?
I did not hear all the details, but apparently he ate some bad mushrooms. It is said he is now emaciated and pale, and his skin exudes a mysterious vapor.
Huh. I can't help but imagine what that must look like. But it's probably better not to think about it.
Agreed. Do not worry yourself with such thoughts. Agreed. Do not worry yourself.
Indeed. Well, then maybe you should pay a visit. And then you could tell me what it looked like.
My thank you so much! Thanks so much! I have gratitude.
Thank you.
Much appreciated.
Let's do this again. You're a good professor. I finally mastered it.
Professor, be nice and...
It was nothing. Of course I got it. You need to butter me up. It was nothing.
It seems I am discovered. I suppose that means assassination is out of the question. At least for now. Unusually watchful. Difficult to steal upon in slumber. Perhaps an odorless, tasteless poison. Lady Edelgard certainly took interest in a difficult one this time. I suppose that question does warrant a response, considering it may mean your life. The answer requires me to explain some of the complex internal politics of the Empire. Are you familiar with Volkard von Arendelle? He is Lady Edelgard's uncle, You may also know him as Lord Arendelle, the Empire's regent. Many years ago, he took Her Majesty and fled to the kingdom of Fargus. Then after a time, he returned to seize power. Together with former Prime Minister Eyre and my father, Lord Arendelle rendered Emperor Ionius IX politically impotent. Lady Edelgard is Ionius IX's daughter. I cannot begin to fathom the depth of her sadness at his betrayal. I see something of Lord Arendelle in you. When I look at you, I feel I can almost see a second self lurking beneath the surface. It is as if you are in constant dialogue with something inside your heart. Something with desires very different from your own. Does that description feel familiar to you at all? Because to me, you seem unpredictable. As though you could turn traitor at any moment. The more I learn about you, the less I like. I had thought you might be of use to Lady Edelgard. But now I am beginning to think you may, through no fault of your own, present too great a risk. I hope you will prove me wrong, Professor. I would hate for this to come to bloodshed.
You can count on me. There is not a noble in the whole Empire more capable than I.
Oh, Ferdinand. I appreciate the confidence, but don't get carried away.
I have no doubt that working together, you and I will excel.
That went better than expected. Our teamwork is clearly improving.
I would say so. Look, Professor, the fruit of our labor.
Each milestone informs the next.
Thank you.
That went better than expected. Our teamwork is clearly improving.
I would say so. Look, Professor, the fruit of our labor.
It's been 10 years. Can I move on yet? Never mind. I know what you'd say. I was just thinking about someone I used to know. Another mercenary I fought alongside. They were killed 10 years ago when Dagda was in conflict with the Empire. It's all I can focus on lately. To be honest, I blame you. I'm just teasing. I know it's not your fault. You just remind me of him. You give off a similar air. It's uncanny. You even have the same inflection, which makes no sense because we only ever spoke Dagden. I don't know what it is, but you feel the same to me. I guess you just remind me of the past. Please, it's not your fault. It's my fault for getting caught up in memories. Still, you always remember your first love, right? That's enough of that. There are more relevant topics to discuss. There's no point in dwelling on the past. Let's talk about the future. Your next move seems apparent. But who knows where I'll end up? Though I may have done enough traveling for one lifetime, I like the idea of having a permanent home. And after all my time here, I've grown quite fond of Fodlan.
Okay.
Last month's fight with the Knights of Saros was a disaster. I am. I never believed in Saros. And my old colleagues are now just enemies. Sometimes it's easier to get by without any personal attachment or religious beliefs.
So, Felix, is the tea to your liking?
It is.
It's nice to relax like this every now and then, isn't it?
It is.
You said some of your equipment is damaged, didn't you?
It is.
Are you not in the mood to talk? We could discuss your family or what's happening in high society. Flavors of tea? Your favorite jokes?
None of those. I already told you, I don't joke.
Of course, only cynicism. Oh, I know. We're holding a small opera in the cathedral soon. I'll be singing too. If you're interested in... But of course you aren't.
You can sing?
I'm sorry. What did you just say? Can I sing? I was only a diva of the Mittelfranc Opera Company, that's all.
Oh, right. I forgot.
You forgot? Am I that uninteresting to you? What must you think of me?
You're insincere and loud, is what I think. But you do make a good sparring partner. And a good tea companion.
Oh.
Anyway, when's the concert?
It's an opera.
And you don't have to come.
You just invited me. You can't tell me not to come. That's for me to decide.
Oh, then you must be there. I'll sing my heart out just for you.
I haven't said I'll go.
Are you going to come or not? If you keep teasing me, I might just pretend to cry.
Fine, I'll go.
Fantastic! I look forward to it.
Yum.
Ah, so delicious. I'm so content in this moment. Felix!
Lysithia, you look mortified.
How long have you been there? Were you watching me? You were, weren't you?
I was, yes.
For once, I thought I had some privacy.
Did you say something?
Huh? Nope. Didn't say anything at all. Here.
What's this for?
I'm buying your silence. With cake. Take it.
I'm not sure what to be silent about.
If people knew I was shoveling cake into my face by the fistful, they'd think me nothing more than a child.
Adults eat cake.
You'll never understand. Just take this, will you?
No, I don't like sweets.
Does your refusal mean you'll be telling everyone about my cake-shoveling ways?
I just don't like sweets, that's all.
Nonsense! Nobody can resist something so delicious. Look, I'm giving you this cake whether you like it or not. Eat it, toss it, throw it at an unsuspecting victim, the choice is yours. Just please, don't mention this to anyone.
What was her problem? And what am I supposed to do with this cake?
Hello, Ferdinand. Wait, that aroma.
Your nose is as sharp as ever, Hubert. Yes, it is a bag of fresh coffee beans.
Why did you buy coffee? You said you don't care for it.
My stance has not changed. Drab, bitter, with that muddy texture. If I have even a sip, my hands start to tremble.
Rather harsh. What are you doing with it, then?
Well, you see, but wait a moment. What is that? Is that an imported tea from the East?
It is indeed. Keen eyes.
Flaunting my favorite drink right in front of me. And you do not even drink tea. Fiendish. It is for Edelgard, I assume.
Before I answer that, I would like to know what you are doing with the coffee.
Well, I...
Is it a gift? Perhaps for someone you fancy?
A gift, yes. For you.
Who is the unlucky... Did you say for me? This coffee is a gift for me. Have I heard you correctly?
Yes, that is what I said. A noble does not go back on his word. Just take it.
I should decline.
Why?
The thought of receiving a gift from you, unbidden and unreciprocated, fills me with revulsion. Therefore, accept this tea as a gift from me.
From me? Are you certain? I would hate to deprive the intended recipient of such a fine tea.
That would be difficult to do, since I bought it with you in mind.
Oh, in that case, thank you. What? You were planning to give this to me all along?
That is what I said.
Really? I... Only one thing to do. We must take a tea break.
Very well. But tea is not what I will be drinking.
Of course. I will make you some coffee.
Then I will prepare the tea.
Hey, Felix! Can I talk to you for a minute?
What is it? I'm listening.
Look, over there! Isn't that a cute kitty?
Oh, I agree. I don't dislike cats.
Here, try this. It's candy, but I promise it isn't sweet.
No, thank you. Sweet or not, I don't eat candy.
Hey, are you busy? I've got this great book and...
What are you doing?
Huh?
Why are you so concerned with me? More importantly, didn't you used to be shy?
Oh, I'm as shy as ever.
Then why are you following me around?
That's, well, you know how ghosts are only scary because you can't see or talk to them?
You're saying I'm a ghost.
What? No, it was just a metaphor.
There you are, foolish as ever.
That's it! You're smiling again!
What?
That's why I've been working so hard to talk to you. I wanted to see you smile again.
I'm disappointed. Such a trivial reason. You're pestering me without a hint of fear just to see me smile. You've really grown up.
Yeah, I guess. Wait. Why are you being nice? Did something terrible happen? This is the part where you get angry at me, isn't it?
Come on. You were saying something about a book I should read?
Really? Well, it's, this one, if you wouldn't mind.
All finished. Time to go. You really must stop sneaking up on me, Shamir.
And what if I don't? I can take you.
Maybe. Either way, it's a waste to fight an ally.
We're allies now? I guess I should be more careful with you. Are you sure it was right to kill them? I believe your mistress told you to let them go.
That is exactly what I will say I did. But leaving them alive would have been a mistake. I did what had to be done.
Is that so?
Maybe you're not just some sycophant. It takes guts to disobey a direct order.
Lady Edelgard's time is rightfully occupied with a great deal of concern and contemplation. Her affairs are of far greater consequence than a trifle like this. Much rests on the decisions she makes. But little details of this kind happen to be my area of expertise, so I simply handle them. Better that than to burden her with needless debate.
Logical through and through, aren't you?
That is how I do things.
I like people who are thorough.
You seem quite thorough in your methods as well.
As a rule, I am. Regarding decisions, I planned on leaving Fodlan after completing my contract. But now I'm starting to think I might stay here.
Stay here? I'm forced to wonder what your intentions might be.
I have no ulterior motives. I've just grown a little fond of you.
Excuse me? You've what?
For someone so intelligent, you're very dense. It's not just about you, though. I've learned to like Lady Edelgard and most everyone else here as well. I wouldn't mind staying on to work as your specialist.
It's a fine offer. But perhaps we should wait until after the war to discuss it thoroughly.
Fair. But you owe me, remember?
Not much I can say to that, is there?
You fought well in that battle. You've improved.
I couldn't have done it without you.
True.
What? Come on! You're supposed to disagree and compliment me instead.
Fine. In the past, you were reckless. Lately, you are less so. You are more considerate of your allies, and much easier to fight alongside.
Whoa, now that's enough. Getting compliments from you is kinda weird. But I get what you mean. I feel safer on the battlefield when you're out there with me, too. I always trust that you've got my back. I guess we make a good team.
I can't disagree.
Hey, do you remember that time I saved you and almost got myself killed? You were pretty mad. That actually had a big impact on me. After that, I decided I had to be able to save you without getting hurt myself. So I started paying more attention. I read your movements in battle and stayed out of your way. Before I knew it, it was almost like I could read your mind.
An interesting concept. We have become a very efficient team, but you will never understand my thoughts.
Not true. I know exactly what you're thinking.
Then prove it. What am I thinking right now?
Right now? Let's see. You're thinking that I'm a reliable ally in battle, and you'd like to keep fighting by my side. And you think we're connected. Yeah, that's right. Even though we come from different places, you feel a bond. That was all just wishful thinking, wasn't it? I guess I'll never know what's actually going on in your head.
Wishful thinking?
Huh? Oh, I probably said too much.
You did indeed.
If you'll excuse me, I gotta go find a hole to bury my head in.
Don't worry, your wishes aren't so far from the truth. Now, shall we be off?
Huh? What do you mean? Shamir, wait!
Manuela, isn't it a bit rude to sigh at someone the moment you see them enter the room?
Hanuman, isn't it a bit rude to tell others how to behave? Besides, I could be sighing about any number of things more interesting than you.
Goodness, you're unusually irritable today. Don't you imagine your attitude a bit excessive? You snap at every little thing, your ill mood on display for one and all. It saddens me to see such behavior from one who should be setting a good example for the younger generation.
Well, listen to the noble lecturing a lowly commoner to be on her best behavior. Oh, wait. I meant to say, the former noble.
I fail to understand how my birth is relevant to the topic at hand. I was merely trying to say that as a fellow adult...
You're not done lecturing yet? Leave me alone and go pester someone else. Maybe leave everyone alone and go focus on your precious crest research.
I don't know what to say to you, Manuel. I was only speaking out of honest concern.
Oh, was that a sigh I heard? Isn't it a bit rude to sigh at someone just because...
Don't be so childish. You are so sensitive to ill will from others, yet you let your own emotions run wild. Why is it that you cannot keep a handle on yourself?
Keep a handle on? Well, I've never. What makes you think you're so much better? Just because you keep your emotions bottled up behind your stupid stony face. Well, it doesn't mean everyone else has to do the same. Stop telling everyone how to behave, Hanuman. It will make you and the rest of us much happier.
I will not stand for this insolence. It is high time someone taught you.
Go on! If you think you can change me, I'd like to see you try. Thought so. You wouldn't dare.
Absolutely insufferable. Hubert, my boy, it's rather rare for the two of us to see one another with no one else around, isn't it?
Yes, I believe it is.
I was good friends with your father, you know. Perhaps this is fate, eh? Of course, when I left the Empire, I broke off my friendship with him. And, well, everyone else.
You were right to sever ties with such a miserable piece of filth.
Sharp words, Hubert. Contemptible though your father may be, he is still your father.
Don't overcomplicate it. I will not forgive him. Ever. Contemptible is just the right word for the wretch. Do you truly know what kind of man my father was?
I assume you're talking about the insurrection of the Seven. At the time, I was already at Garrick Mark. I know nothing more than hearsay. That said, I found it hard to believe that Lord Vestra would challenge the Emperor like that.
Yet that's exactly what he did. Since the dawn of the Adrestian Empire, House Vestra has served House Hresvelg as the Emperor's right hand. My father spat on a legacy of loyalty and devotion that had lasted 1,100 years. He conspired with the ministers to usurp power from the Emperor. And Lady Edelgard.
In your father's defense, the Emperor was attempting to take power from the Seven Houses. The Emperor's reform was an attempt to concentrate power in the hands of the throne. The nobles put a stop to that. Emperor Ionius lost the ensuing power struggle.
Now it is the nobles' turn to suffer defeat. Her Majesty will crush all who oppose her.
You hope she can cease this never-ending conflict? That's quite a goal, Hubert.
How the crimson rain of pain it came, falling hard upon a land aflame, when the sacred blade it split the sky until the heavens heard our cry. In the hour of vengeance, will you heed the call? On the red fields of revenge, will you help avenge? We must fight strong and stand tall.
Oh, Ferdinand, that song.
Manuela, hello. What a treat. It is most rare to see you at the training grounds. I have never had the honor of sparring with a princess. Why not grab a sword?
Ferdinand, that's called changing the subject. That song you were singing,
Is it the one you said made such an impression on you?
So you heard me. I hope it was not too grating on your ears.
You've nothing at all to be embarrassed about. I'm pleased if one of my songs stayed with you like that. Oh, it really takes me back. I remember the big battle in the first act.
How the crimson rain of pain it came, falling hard upon a land aflame, when the sacred blade it split the sky, until the heavens heard our cry. In the hour of vengeance, will you heed the call? On the red fields of revenge, will you help avenge? We must fight strong and stand tall!
Wow. My heyday is behind me. That's for sure.
No, that was wonderful. Exactly the voice I recall from my childhood. To have witnessed this performance in such an intimate setting, I am deeply moved. I cannot stop trembling. I feel as though I am going to cry. You have shaken me to my very core.
All right, Ferdinand, relax. I can see that it's affected you deeply.
You made a little boy's cherished dream come true. Perhaps you can help realize one more.
Another one? And what would that be?
Would you do the sword dance with me? The one that accompanied the song? It had a part for a male performer, if I recall. I would be truly honored.
I'm sure I can't do it as well now as I could then, but you're just so adorably... you. I can't resist.
Thank you so much. That has long been a dream of mine, and you made it a reality.
I gotta say, Ferdinand, you're full of surprises. It was like dancing with a pro. Perfect timing, always in step.
All thanks to you. You inspired me.
Or perhaps it was you who inspired me.
Ah, Linhart. Reading as studiously as ever, I see. Anything to do with crests?
Hello, Professor Hanneman. Actually, this book's about fishing.
I didn't realize you were interested in fishing. What an unexpected discovery. I had heard that you were only interested in crests, to the exclusion of all else. As it were, I had rather thought I could train you as my successor. Should we get to know one another better?
I'm sorry to betray your expectations. Truth be told, I've been thinking of giving up on my crest research.
What? Whatever for? Don't tell me you believe fishing to be a more worthwhile pursuit.
No, it's nothing to do with fishing. I adore the subject of crests. But to study them, you have to consult the people who bear them, right? I just don't have the energy for that.
It is an unavoidable hardship, I admit, but the satisfaction of making a real breakthrough is second to none.
I'm sure the satisfaction of catching a fish is pretty great, too.
Consider this, child. Luring fish from the depths pales in comparison to untangling the mysteries of a quest. Why? It all comes down to purpose. Purpose, I say.
Calm down. I get it. Really.
Evidently, you do not. You must have something to work toward in life. The ultimate goal of fishing is to eat the fish. The goal of solving the mysteries of crests is... Well, you must find that for yourself. What do you hope to uncover once everything is finally explained? What motivates you to keep digging deeper?
I had never thought about it like that. Perhaps if I did have a goal, I might share your enthusiasm on the subject.
I would be liking that greatly.
Delicious! After a scrumptious meal like that, I feel that I can really seize the day.
Sounds fun! Let me show you my cooking talent. A little more secret spice, and... hey! No peeking!
I've been informed of the surprise attack. That information could be devastating were the enemy to find out. It moves me to know I've been trusted with it. Edelgard and those within the army, they really do trust me. Initially, I had my own motives for joining the Black Eagle Strike Force, but now, all I want is to support Edelgard.
Excitement in my heart for secret tactics. I enjoy attacks that are surprising. Yes, hunting is doing surprise attacks on prey. Surprise attacks are safe with friends. Fewer injuries, that is a wonderful thing. I have no liking for the thought of losing anyone.
This was a trying month, but we did manage to hold Garrig Mach. If only just. The power of Sedith and Flame was certainly a sight to behold. The Archbishop's supporters were strong, but with this victory, we have all but cornered the Church of Saros and its knights. The goddess above shall give way to the darkness that has long dwelled below. I have a request for you. I have a request for you. Quest for you.
Well,
oh, how have we come to this? Fighting the Archbishop and her knights? I'd never imagined. I hate this. So much. Professor, I tried. I gave treatment to everyone I could, but lives were still lost. The infirmary is as much a morgue right now as it is a place of care and healing.
What if there's a school of sorcery in Ferdiad? Which is staffed by the top minds of magical research. The study of crests and sorcery should not be separate. I've often thought, I never imagined I might end up invading the place with an army, though. Not how I imagined it at all. I've often thought I should pay them a visit someday.
Thank you.
help me? Nice job.
Okay, I'm thinking...
The old general who serves the Roe family in Aryan Road is known for being a curmudgeon. Even if we invited him to join our side, he probably just wouldn't respond.
Tolerate obstacles. Let's keep up the pace. Your death is not in vain.
Cornelia, I have a report from our scouts. The Imperial Army that departed from Garrick Mach en route to the capital now appears to be marching here.
What did you just say?
The speed of the Army's movement quickens. They will be here to invade within days. I just sent some of my troops to support the capital. It is likely to be a fierce fight.
How could this be? I have not heard a thing about... I understand now. I am the target.
You? Are you sure they do not mean to take Aryan Road for strategic reasons?
It would appear so from the outside. However, the circumstances are not that simple. And will you calm yourself? It will not be a fierce fight whatsoever. The sweet children I have prepared will protect Aryan Road well.
Cornelia.
Aryan Road is a fortress city that was built about 400 years ago. Originally a base on the front lines of the battle against the kingdom, it was built using Imperial money and technology.
However, the head of House Roe secretly planned to betray the Empire. As the fortress neared completion, it was rebuilt as a base to defend against the Empire. When the fortress was completed, House Roe declared its vassalage to the kingdom.
Since then, Aryan Road has never fallen. Not once. The beautiful white walls that protect it against its enemies have earned it the nickname, the Silver Maiden. In the end, that is all it is to the Empire. The Silver Maiden stands as a bitter memory.
We will now be destroying that memory. The past is the past. Now is now.
A fortress that has never fallen. I can't wait to make it fall.
How savage of you. And yet, I must say I agree with the sentiments. Let us take the sturdy Aryan Road and continue our march against the kingdom.
An invincible fortress? Sounds perfect.
Unfortunately, it will soon no longer be invincible. The Silver Maiden's iron skin is about to be damaged. It's sad, really.
Is it silver or iron? Use your language with clarity, please.
Really, Lin, there must be a better way to say that. Since we are attacking a heavily guarded place, we must take extra care to prevent allies from getting injured.
Thank you, everyone. I'm counting on all of you. Now, let's resume our advance.
This battle is for the future of Fodlan.